Over the last few weeks, happy new year, by the way, I have been diving into DaVinci Resolve and really looking for things that I might have missed because I was too focused on my own personal workflow. And I actually did find something in the color page, believe it or not, that I'd never seen before. And I'm pretty sure it's been there the whole time, but when you use it and you add it to your own workflow, it can actually help you get cleaner, quicker qualifications and help you really dial in the look that you're going for. And that tool is called the 6 Vector Presets. And if you come over into the top menu of DaVinci Resolve, doesn't really matter what page you're in, but the only way you can work with it is in the color page. So that's where I am moving on. If we come over to this top menu and hit color and come down to presets, we've got 6 vector: green, yellow, red, magenta, blue, and cyan. And if you know anything about color grading and are familiar with the color wheels, you'll know that those are the 6 colors that we deal with all the time when we're working with color. So let's take a look at how to use these presets. I've got a clip here of my color checker passport. If you don't know what that is, it's actually sitting right over here. It's an amazing tool that will help you color correct your footage super, super fast, especially in DaVinci Resolve. You'll do it basically automatically. I've got a whole video on it. It'll be linked below, as well as the link to pick one of these up if you haven't done so already. Now, I've already done my basic color correction. So I've got my luminance, my contrast, my balance, and my saturation all good to go. So let's take a look at adding these presets into our node tree. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Alt S to add a new node. And then I'm going to hit Alt L to add a layer node. And we're going to end up adding 5 layer nodes. So we'll end up having a total of 6 layers. So we're gonna hit Alt L, 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 and L. So that gives us 6 layers right there. Let's go ahead and highlight all those, drag them up so you can see them. And next thing, just for organizational purposes, what we're gonna do is label these nodes in accordance with the preset. So this one is going to be green. This one will be yellow. And this one will be red, and you get the idea. Once you're done labeling your nodes, go ahead and click on that green node and come over to color, presets, 6 vector green. And we'll do the same thing, color, presets, 6 vector yellow, red. And let's go ahead and do it for the rest of these, magenta, blue, and cyan. Now let's go ahead and hit Shift H to turn on our highlights, come up to that green node again, take a look at what it did, and you can see that it selected that green square in the color checker. And we can actually clean this up a little bit by coming over to our qualifiers. Let's widen this selection a little bit. Not so much that it picks up anything else though. Go ahead and denoise that. Do some clean black, maybe not the clean black, we'll leave that down, but we will do some clean white and blur the radius just a tad. And if we turn off our highlights and we come into our primaries wheels, and let's say we wanted to boost the saturation of the green, we could do that. You can see we're a little bit more saturated. You can really see it if I boost the color boost. There you go, now we're very, very green. And I can go ahead and maybe change the hue a little bit, can make it a little bit more cyan. If I come this way, we've got an orange. So the 6 vector presets really have the ability to zero in on a particular color that you want to manipulate, so you can really dial in that look you're going for. Now with the color checker passport, granted, that's easy. There's a square for each color, so you don't really have to think about it. But what about in a more practical application? Like, how do you actually add this into your workflow? Now, personally, I would do it after creating the overall look of the image. So let's go ahead and take a look at another clip here. This is a clip of S-Log footage that I got off of ArtGrid. ArtGrid's where I get all of my stock footage. If you want to check them out, they'll be linked below. You actually get 2 free months on top of your annual subscription if you sign up using that link. So, you know, that's not bad. Now, I use DaVinci Wide Gamut to bring this into a Rec 709 color space, and I actually kind of like the way that this looks, so I didn't really do any correction on it. I also added my creative look here, which is just kind of a classic teal and orange. I know that's kind of always what I do when I'm doing color grading stuff, but it's so simple to do that it just doesn't waste any time. So anyway, let's go ahead and really dial in the look we're going for by adding our 6 vector presets. So again, we're gonna start off with a serial node, and then we're gonna add our 5 layer nodes. Bring them up so you can see it. Again, we're going to label these, and let's drop in those presets. And let's turn on our highlights and take a look at what all of these qualifications gave me. So we've got a little bit of green in here, not too much, and then we've got some more yellow. We've got some more of those leaves, the ones that are up against the branches, which is why they're coming across as yellow instead of green. Then we've got red, which is mostly the coat and a little bit of the bark from the trees. And moving on to magenta, we've got a little bit more of the coat and then some little artifacts around here that will probably clean up a little bit. Then we've got blue, which is giving you some of the leaves, mostly snow though. And finally, cyan, which is giving us most of the leaves and even more of the snow. Now, the biggest thing that I want to do with this footage is make that red coat pop out a little bit more. So we're gonna come over to red. We're gonna clean this up just a little bit by maybe bringing down the width and playing with the center. Go ahead and denoise just a little bit. We'll do clean black, which will get rid of the rest of that tree. Do clean white to bring in some more of that coat. Then we'll come down to magenta. We'll do the same thing. We'll denoise a little bit. We'll do some clean black to get rid of those artifacts. Some clean white to bring in some more of the coat. Blur the radius just a little bit. And that should be good. Now let's go ahead and turn off our highlights. And like I said, I wanna give this a little bit of a pop. So what I'm gonna do is come over to my curves, make sure I'm in custom curves. I'm gonna turn on my editable splines. I'm gonna select my red node, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of pop. Come down to magenta, do the same thing. Let's go ahead, select those. That's better. That's much better. Next thing I want to do is bring down the luminance and the saturation of all of this foliage. So if we come over, we're probably going to be working mostly in the yellow and the cyan because that's where most of it lives. So if we click on yellow and we turn on our highlights, you can see that all the foliage that's up against trees or wood or anything like that is giving us a lot of saturation, a good bit of luminance. So let's go ahead and just turn off our highlights, and we're going to drop the saturation of that yellow down to say 45 and bring down that luminance just a bit. Let's turn off our editable splines and bring that down. Do a quick before and after. And that didn't do a lot, but it did enough. It's always those little things, those little details that really do all of the work. Let's go ahead and move on to cyan, which is down here, and turn on our highlights. Now we've got some snow in here as well. I'm gonna try and get rid of that by coming into my qualifiers. I'm gonna bring down my luminance. There we go, get rid of that snow. Get rid of that snow. Let's go ahead and denoise a little bit. Clean white, that'll work. Blur the radius. Turn off our highlights. Let's go ahead. What'll happen if we drop this all the way down? Not a lot. So let's go ahead and bring our saturation down to 45. Come back over to curves, bring down our luminance. Quick before and after. You probably can't see it because it's so minute, but it did drop that just a little bit to make that red pop out a little bit more and make it a little less harsh on the eyes. Next, let's take a look at our blues. This is gonna give us most of the rest of the foliage on our trees. Again, we wanna get rid of that snow. So let's come over to our qualification. and drop the luminance until the snow goes away. There we go. Denoise just a tad. Clean white, blur the radius, turn off our highlights. Same thing, drop that saturation down to 45. Drop our luminance down. And then the last place where we had some foliage was in green. So let's do Shift H. It didn't give us a lot, but it gave us enough. We'll come over to our qualifications. We are going to widen that just a bit to give us some more. There we go. Clean white, blur the radius, turn off our highlights, drop the saturation, and bring down the luminance. So individually, that really didn't do much, but if we select our green, yellow, blue, and cyan, turn that off, it's still a very minute difference, but it's just enough. Really, the big difference that we had was with this red magenta, where we really made that coat pop out of the screen. And now if we select all of those presets, turn them off. There's a slight variation here. And again, that red makes a big difference. All right, next thing I want to do is actually desaturate this snow. We're getting to the end of our grade, so let's go ahead and hit Alt S to add a new serial node. We're gonna come into our qualifications. We're gonna turn off hue. We're gonna turn off saturation. And we're just gonna bring that luminance so it's only selecting our snow. Shift H, go ahead and desaturate that. And after that, we can finish this up with a vignette and then desaturate those blacks. And then here's a before. And an after. So the six vector presets are really quickly becoming an integral part of my color grading workflow, but I'll be the first to admit that it does take some added steps and a little bit more knowledge of the color grading process in order to really take full advantage of them. If you want to know more about my color grading workflow that I had before I discovered this tool, click here. And for more tools, tips, and tricks that'll make you a better video editor, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you don't miss anything. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.